incredible. The winning moment right there. 15-year-old Brynn Cartelli from Team Kelly won The Voice last night, earning a recording contract with Universal Music Group Republic Records and making her the youngest artist ever to win. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
You squeaked in that moment. Was that a squeak that we heard?
Yes. I think Brynn gave me a really big hug and it just came out. I was like, ah!
When he was hugging you, he wasn't like, you did it, you scoundrel, you beat me. He didn't whisper in your ear
or
anything?
No, he was really excited.
He's nice for you?
Yes.
What a good guy.
Yeah.
What's it like at the end? We're talking about your journey leading up to this. So at the very end, you got to be exhausted. You're waiting to hear. There's four great people left. Like, what was going through your mind?
Yeah, 15 years old, you're probably like, about time.
No, I was up there and I didn't know what to expect. I didn't think I was going to win. I was like, I'm cool. And I'm just going to pull up as runner-up. And I was going to be so happy with that. And when they announced my name, I was like, oh, okay, like this is a real thing now and I have to like, I'm gonna do this. And so I'm so happy with what happened. And it's just really inspiring because it's to know that America like believed in me and this got me here. It makes me wanna do something. It makes me wanna get music out as soon as I can and do everything I can to stay relevant and in this industry.
Do you wish you'd have picked Team Blake maybe? No?
I mean, I
no
love
regrets?
Him. I love him, but I love Kelly.
So you like Kelly Clarkson more? That's what you're telling us right here.
I mean,
live, is that you like Kelly Clarkson more than Blake Shelton? I think that's sure. What you're saying.
I mean, I think that's by default.
You heard it here first.
Well, I'm sorry, Blake.
Kelly, what's the best advice? What has she said to you?
She's told me that I just in this whole experience, it's going to be crazy and there's going to be a lot of things flying in different directions, but to stay grounded and have fun with it and to enjoy myself has been one of her lessons that she's really driven into me. And it's really important, and now more than ever, I'm really starting to understand that because it's been just ever since I won, it's been really, really crazy. And I'm trying to find as much time as I can to enjoy myself, and I feel like I'm doing a pretty good job, but I definitely am going to need to keep remembering that.
Probably done with high school, though. Forget that, right?
No, I still want to do school.
You still want to go to school? Not me. If I won The Voice, I wouldn't be here neither. I'd be out, you know.
On like, the beach?
Yeah, waving to people. Or, you know, celebrity boy. You going to have a celebrity boyfriend?
Yeah, Jeff's got it all set up for you.
Yeah,
tell
yeah.
Him.
So at NBC, we'll get you a celebrity boyfriend. Someone your age. Don't worry. We're not going to set you up with one of these Kardashian people. And then you guys have a baby. It's
no,
a whole
she's
thing.
15.
No, not now. They have to date for like 3 or 4 years. Then they have a celebrity baby. Then we sell the pictures to probably this show. Listen, it's going to be great. We got big plans for you.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah,
what
yeah.
about your friends at school? Were some of your friends there last night?
They were there last week.
Last week.
Yeah, and it was really cool that my school has been going crazy because I go to a small public school, so
nice.
It's really cool to see the support back at home. I honestly didn't expect it. I was like, they might think this is cool. Even
yeah.
like coming out here for the live playoffs back when there was 24 of us, I was like, they might kind of like this, but I didn't really know. And now I'm here, and it's like, oh, I think they like it now.
Do you want to send a message to maybe anyone that said you couldn't do it or throw yeah. in a teacher's face by name
no.
or something?
I won't, but here I am. So.
Yeah, oh, there is
yeah,
one.
Maybe like an ex-boyfriend or something. Like, you stupid idiot. You missed out.
No.
You could have been here.
Let's
on
call
the
him
voice.
Tommy. Hey,
yeah,
Tommy.
No. Tommy, you little cretin.
Yeah, Tommy,
you
we got
it.
You right there.
Eighth grade formal. Who needs you?
Yeah, blow that off. Your social media, what did you start with and what are you now?
Yesterday morning, I'm pretty sure it was at 89,000.
Nice.
And now it's at 120,000.
And what did
like
it start
that.
With when you were just back at school before
oh,
the show?
Like before it all started, yeah. I had 3,000.
That's wow. a lot. 2,000.
2 or 3,000 something.
This is on the cards. Will you follow Kit on Twitter?
Please tell him okay. I have no followers.
Okay.
Tell people.
It's on the card. I don't know.
It's the young. It's a young person's thing. What do your mom and dad say about all this? They've been so cute. I feel like they kind of tag teamed this journey with you.
Yeah, they did. They went back and forth of being out here with me, and since I'm so young, I have to have a guardian with me, and so it's been really nice to be able to have that. And I get to go to school for a break, but they've really grounded me and kept me sane in this whole experience. Because I mean, it's so easy to get caught up in everything. It's crazy schedules. It's you're always on camera. You can forget about like normal things. And they definitely reminded me of everything back at home to keep me just where I am.
Look at this. I mean, Jeff, I think of the poise every time we would see you perform. I would think about your age. You're on national TV
yeah.
with everybody judging you, sitting in front of four massive superstars,
yeah.
and you're performing like this week after week. How did you find that calm?
I didn't think about it. I didn't think about it like that. It was something I sing all the time. Everyone there sings all the time, and everyone has a really deep respect for music, even the coaches, because they're really just normal people at the end of the day. So every time I went
out. Well, not Adam Levine, but yeah.
Every time I went out, it was just like, I'm just doing what I do all the time and just had to bring my best each week. And I worked really hard on every song I sang and I just wanted to put my best out there and just, yeah.
Whose career would you like to emulate? Is there one person that you've sort of been looking at?
Besides Kanye West, who, whose career would you really like to?
I think I want to go down a Tori Kelly kind of path. Like, not huge, obviously, you know, like, not, she's in like a, I feel like she's in the perfect amount of success where she's so grounded and she's really humble and involved with her family and her town. But at the same time, she has this really big career and a lot of people idolize
but
her.
But what about Celine Dion? She makes way more money. Do you know what I'm saying?
I know what you're
saying. So maybe say Celine Dion.
Celine Dion, hey now.
You say Dion. Yeah.
Yeah,
Celine
Dion. For that, I mean, I think maybe that's a probably more expensive.
She's amazing too.
Yeah, okay, good. Good answer.
Well, we predict huge things for you. Congratulations.
Thank
We're
you
with
so
you
much.
Every step of the way. Let's hear
you
it for
Brynn. You crushed it, and congratulations.
You killed it. Oh, how incredible.